Hey guys, welcome back to News to Astonish, where we discuss comics, movies, games, and more. My name is Ronnie, and today I'm here to share with you this article that I found on Superhero Hype, where Letitia Wright speaks out about her feelings filming Black Panther 2 without Chadwick Boseman. So she states that it would be strange to make Black Panther 2 without Chadwick Boseman. If you guys don't know already, Chadwick Boseman died back in August. And fans and pretty much the whole world was in shock when they found out about these news. He had cancer. This is something that he did not share with his fans or the movie crew or Marvel Studios or Disney. This is only something that he kept to himself with his family because he didn't want everybody to, like, you know, pity him or feel sorry for him when he was going through cancer treatment and chemo. Anyways, I'm here to talk to you about Letitia Wright, about her feelings of, you know, about filming Black Panther 2. And why it would be strange to film the movie without him. So if we go ahead and direct our attention to the article here on Superhero Hype, it states, Letitia Wright says it would be strange to make Black Panther 2 without Chadwick Boseman. News of Chadwick Boseman's death in August stunned everybody, especially those who worked with him in Black Panther 2. In the weeks following his passing, Boseman's classmates shared a series of moving tributes. One of these tributes came from Letitia Wright, who played Boseman's on-screen sister, Shuri. Wright has broken her silence on what it would be like to film Black Panther 2 without Boseman by her side. Wright was asked about the status of Black Panther 2 during a recent interview with Net A Porter, but it shouldn't come as a surprise that the film's cast and crew haven't begun to discuss how to move forward with the sequel. Wright's just still mourning Chad, so it's not something I even want to think about. We're just still mourning Chad, so it's not something I even want to think about, said Wright. The thought of doing it without him is kind of strange. We're just grieving at the moment, so it's trying to find the light in the midst of it. Marvel Studios hired Ryan Coogler to write and direct Black Panther 2 in late 2018. At last year's D23 event, Kevin Feige announced that the movie would hit theaters on May 6, 2022. Marvel was planning to start shooting the film next March before Boseman's death sent shockwaves throughout the entertainment industry. Thankfully, fans have largely understood the need for the proper mourning period, but it seems like everyone has their own idea for how Marvel should proceed with the sequel. Some think it would be fine if T'Challa was recast. However, this would inevitably result in plenty of comparisons to Boseman's take on the character. Wright will next appear in Kenneth Branagh's upcoming adaptation, Agatha Christie's Death on the Nile. She also has a role in Steve McQueen's anthology film series, Small Axe, which will premiere on Amazon Prime. Meanwhile, Netflix has just released a trailer for Ma Rainey's Black Bottom, which marks Boseman's final performance. You can share your thoughts on Wright's remarks about Black Panther 2 in the comment section below. I wanted to share this for a few reasons and, you know, for personal reasons. If you guys don't know already, obviously, I've been a fan of superhero films since I was a kid. And I've grew up with the original stuff like Michael Keaton's Batman, Tobey Maguire's Spider-Man, and so on and so forth. Those were the greats. I mean, to me, they're the greats. I love their performances. They were fantastic. Michael Keaton was fantastic as Batman. And a lot of people would agree that he's probably the best Batman on screen. And Tobey Maguire was the best Spider-Man. And obviously, a lot of people would agree that Tobey Maguire was the best Spider-Man adaptation. I can agree to the most for the most part, but I can also disagree to an extent. Here's my issue, right? I mean, a lot of wrong can come out of this. Let's say if Disney Marvel decided to recast the character T'Challa Black Panther, people would start sending hate mail, death threats, you name it. I feel like if the character was to get recast, a lot of people would just be entirely upset and the shit would just hit the fan because people would feel like, oh, how can you disrespect Chadwick Boseman like this? To me personally, I feel like Chadwick Boseman would be honored if his character that he portrayed on screen fantastically, might I add, would be replaced. I mean, I feel like anybody would feel honored if they were succeeded by someone else. The fact of the reality is that eventually it'll happen. I mean, actors come and go from movie roles all the time. Do I wish these actors can play the same character forever? Yes and no, because while I do enjoy the performances, you got to move on and you need to experience something different. I'm always curious about how an actor would portray a character differently from the last. Like Tobey Maguire, for example, when I heard news that Andrew Garfield was going to play Spider-Man, I was like, oh, the guy from the Social Network movie. That's where I first discovered Andrew Garfield. When I saw the news that he was going to play Spider-Man, I was like, oh, that's incredible. I think he's perfect. He kind of resembles like a modern Spider-Man. So I think he'd be fantastic in the role. My point is that while, yes, you can totally be fans of like the greats like Christopher Reeve's Superman or Michael Keaton's Batman or Tobey Maguire's Spider-Man, you need to have an open mind because eventually there will come a time where those characters, where those actors will be too old to play a particular character that you like. It's going to happen. It's inevitable. People come and go. And I hate to sound like I'm being very cold and straight up with you, but it's the honest truth. And another thing that kind of bothers me is that people tend to praise these actors for the wrong reasons. And what I mean by that, and to elaborate on that, everybody would probably agree that Christopher Reeve gave the best performance as Superman because he is Superman. Everybody would feel like Hugh Jackman gave the best performance of Wolverine because he is Wolverine, right? To me, I'm like, yeah, they delivered fantastic performance. They gave it over 100%. But they're actors, and eventually they're going to want to move on to other things. While a lot of people would basically like hate that or feel disappointed or betrayed, it's the reality of it, and we need to have an open mind. I'm always thrilled to see actors taking new roles or an actor taking on a role that was portrayed by another actor. I'm always open to like different interpretations of a character because eventually you're going to want something different. And not to sound like I'm babbling on, but I have to like address these points in order to get my point across, because that's the point is that don't ever feel like you need to like an actor that portrays a character because the majority agrees that they delivered the best performance. I mean, I feel like Christian Bale delivered the best performance as Batman, honestly. I mean, not going to lie. While others can say that Ben Affleck delivered the best performance as Batman, I personally disagree with that. I didn't really like his portrayal as Batman or Bruce Wayne. I liked Michael Keaton and Christian Bale's portrayal of Bruce Wayne and Batman. That's just my opinion. You see, you don't need to be afraid to give out your opinion. If you feel differently and people shame you and ridicule you for feeling differently about a certain subject, screw them. Forget it. Overall, I'm open to the idea of the character of Black Panther T'Challa being recast or having his character killed off and having Shuri take on the mantle of Black Panther. That's pretty much my point that I want to get across. So, just so I don't get any flack or hate for this, I'm pretty much open to anything. Because at the end of the day, Marvel and Disney has the final say. Anyways, guys, thank you all so much for watching. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and click on bell notifications so y'all don't miss anything. Let me know your thoughts about Letitia Wright feeling this way. And I can understand why Letitia Wright would feel strange. I mean, I'm sure those actors were really close on set for the most part when they filmed. Because it's like being with your classmates, if you really think about it, or your coworkers, where essentially they become family. So go ahead and post your comments down below. Let me know. And as always, thank you all so much for watching. And I will see you all in the next comic panel.